GoTots, it's Bess here. I hope you've been having a really lovely week. You know what? I love days like today because I get to hang out in our awesome GoTots studios. I am so thankful for Monica painting these beautiful pictures on the walls. I'm so thankful she's such a talented artist. Just look at all that she's painted on it. We've got owls and bears. Oh, and look, even a little cheeky one climbing up the tree. We've got deer and we've got squirrels. And on some other walls, we've got birds and butterflies, and it's just so lovely and cozy in here. You know what? Next time you see Monica, make sure to give her a big thank you. This reminds me of what we've been learning about. We've been learning all about how we can praise Jesus. We've marched, we've lifted our hands, we've sung for him. And another way that we can praise God and let him know how great we think he is by thanking him. Just like I'm thankful for Monica, I am so thankful for Jesus and all the things that he's done for us. You know, he never lets us down or leaves us alone. And I know when I pray, he's always listening. He is such a good friend to me, and he wants to be such a good friend to you too. One thing that we can definitely be thankful for is that Jesus is a healer. You know what? I think Horace has a story to tell us all about Jesus being the healer.
Hi everyone. Listen carefully as I tell you this story. One day, Jesus was walking with his disciples. They were on the way to Jerusalem, walking along the border between two countries. They were just coming up to a village when 10 men who had leprosy met him. Leprosy was a horrible skin disease. Because they were so ill, they stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, "Jesus! Jesus! Have pity on us!" Jesus saw them and he said, "Go show yourselves to the priests." And as they began to walk towards the temple, they were totally healed. Wow! One of them, when he saw he was healed, ran back to Jesus, praising God in a very loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. He wasn't even a Jew. Jesus said, "Weren't all 10 of you healed? Where are the other 9? Has no one else come to give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then Jesus said, "Rise and go. Your faith has made you well."
Wow, he healed 10 people, but only one person remembered to come back and say thank you. I don't know about you, but when I was little, my mom taught me it was very important to say thank you. It lets the person know you appreciate what they've done. Maybe God has healed you. Did you remember to say thank you? When we say thank you, we're stopping and we're appreciating all the things that we've been given and all the things that have been done for us. You know, there are so many things to be thankful for, especially things we can be thankful to God for. We can be thankful for the flowers, the beautiful leaves that are falling, for all the animals, for all of our friends and families, for the yummy fruit and veggies that we can eat. There are so many things to be thankful for. Well, what else can we be thankful for? I know that I'm so thankful that I get to talk to you through these videos. I'm really thankful for my car, which allows me to go to all the different schools that I work in. I'm thankful for my toothbrush that helps me keep my teeth clean and healthy. I'm thankful for peanuts. They're the yummiest food in the world to me. And I'm really thankful for my friends who've helped me make all of these videos so that I can talk to you. I think we should do a fun craft to remind us to be thankful. So this week, I thought it would be fun to make some thankful posters. So all you're going to need is a big piece of paper. You can use one this size or a bigger piece. You can get some pictures that you can cut out, in which case you need scissors, so either children's scissors or get an adult to help you. And if you're doing that, you'll also need some glue. You can use a stick or PVA. Two little wooden sticks would be fantastic if you've got them. If not, you could always get some sticks outside, as long as you make sure they're nice and clean first. Or you can just draw, that's fine. I've got some fun things to stick on, but really all you're going to need is something to draw with. So it's up to you to be as creative as you'd like to be. So to start off with, all I'm going to do is get my big jumbo crayons and I'm going to divide my paper into 9. So you might want an adult to help you to try and make it even. So you can use a ruler, so it's straight lines, or you can just do wiggly lines. Now I like wiggly lines, I think they look more fun. So I have 3 lines going one way, well, 2 lines going one way, making 3 areas. And now, 2 lines going the other way. So now I have a grid, and now you're gonna play tic-tac-toe. No, I'm joking. Alright, so instead what we're going to do is in each of the sections we are going to put something in that we are thankful for. So one thing I am very thankful for, well not one thing, 2 people actually, are my mum and dad. So I'm going to cut out a lovely picture of them at my grandparents' house. That's another thing I'm very thankful for, getting to visit my grandparents. I've got a picture of my parents and I'm going to put some glue on. So you can make this a collage by sticking lots of different things on it. You can really just do whatever you want to do. So I'm gonna write, Mum and Dad. And you know what else I'm thankful for? I love flowers. And luckily, in the same picture, we've got lots of flowers. I'm gonna cut out the flowers. I'm gonna stick some flowers onto my picture. I think the flowers would look really good down here. And it's okay if your things overlap a little bit. That just makes it look prettier. All right, so those are things I've got to cut out. And now something else that I'm thankful for. I'm super thankful for the stars in the sky. I don't know about you, but I love looking up at night time, especially when I'm not in the city. It's always so cool to see how big our universe is. I've got to have a blue one because that's my favourite colour. And now I'm going to get a silver one. to draw?
For me.
I'm gonna draw beautiful flowers in here. And what else I'm thankful for? I'm really thankful for laughter. I think laughter makes everything better. So I'm gonna do a big. And drawing a big smiley face. I think laughter makes everything better. I'm really thankful that I have an amazing job. I work for the NH. The NHS. I'm super thankful that I have such an amazing job with them, but I'm also super thankful for how well the people who work for the NHS have been taking care of so many of us. You know anyone who works for the NHS and is a frontline worker, make sure you let them know how thankful you are for them. What else am I thankful for? I'm really thankful that I had such an amazing summer. I love the warm weather. I'm really thankful that as of this Sunday, GoTots gets to be in church again. I'm thankful for my favorite animal. Can any of you tell what it is? And last, but most certainly not least, I am super thankful I am super thankful for Jesus for coming to earth to save us. Awesome. I'm thankful for so many more things than I've even drawn on here. But it's great to have this to be a constant reminder of just how much God has given us. I think I'm going to put this up somewhere in the GoTots room that will remind me every time I come here. Now, next time you come here, let's see if you can find where I put it. As always, if you make a craft that we've done on GoTots, you can send it in to the email address listed below. We hope that you are healthy and staying happy, and we can't wait to see you again. Until next time, bye!